yogurt, everything, which I told you.
Mommy cooking.
We make.
Did you have your blender, milk, sugar?
Mommy, I thought you were anything. Can you just? Can you?
I have sent it in the.
I thought tomorrow's cooking.
Mommy, it is just one activity along with
it. I thought tomorrow's cooking.
How many of you have it ready with you?
Mataji, I don't have it ready with me.
I have Mataji.
Very good. So if you do not have it, you can just check. Yeah. You know what? If you do not have it, you need something.
Mataji, can you add me to Govinda group? I'm only in Madhava and Dhamma.
I sent it yesterday.
One second, Mataji.
You just need 5 things. Milk, yogurt, your blender, and sugar. And little cardamom.
We do have these things.
Okay.
Can you come?
What's the ingredients?
Mataji, what are we doing?
Mataji.
We are first doing about Ekadashi and then we will talk about the what we are doing for Ekadashi. Okay? So everybody can see these slides?
Mataji.
Everybody
yes,
can
Mataji.
See these slides?
Yes. Mataji.
Okay.
Mataji.
So now...
Mataji, okay. Your talk is over. I'm going to put everyone on mute all, or do you want them to be asked?
Yeah, they can be on mute, and when I ask a question, then they can answer.
Mataji, I have a question.
Mataji, I have a question.
Yes, Tanya.
Tomorrow is Ekadashi for me.
Yes, yes, tomorrow is Ekadashi. I've just put up this slide. For everyone, tomorrow is Ekadashi, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Okay. So now. We are all going to be listening. How many of you have your listening ears?
Oh, what will you do?
Mataji.
Listening ears.
Me.
Mataji, unmute yourself. Mataji, please.
Okay, so now, last time, remember, last week, that was the first of June. We saw about Ekadashi and then we saw what was the importance of the science behind the Ekadashi, right? We saw the science behind Ekadashi, what was there. Now today we are going to see what is the spiritual background of Ekadashi. And I had so many wonderful messages from your parents that you all wonderful kids did Ekadashi. Some of them did Nirjal Ekadashi for half day. Some of you did for the full day. And I was so happy. We all teachers were so happy about it. Pat your backs for it. Okay. I do not see anyone on video. Yes, I see some of you on video. Okay. So now what are we going to do today is we are going to see that we saw science behind the Ekadashi. Why I need to do the Ekadashi? Because it is good for my body. It is going to clean my body. It is going to make my mind healthy. Now we have to see what is the spiritual science behind Ekadashi. Why am I supposed to do the Ekadashi? I know the science, but now we will see what does Ekadashi really mean according to our scriptures. Okay. So now see over here, Ekadashi, the name itself. See, whenever you have your name, right? Somebody may ask you, what is the meaning of your name? Then you say, like, suppose it is my name is like Sita Priti. Then it says, okay, the one who loves Sita, okay? Or a servant of Sita Devi. So then somebody will say, like, okay, then what does Ekadashi mean? Does Ekadashi also have a split of name? Then yes. Okay. Last time we have seen that Ekadashi is the 11th day of the moon cycle, right? From the waxing and the mooning and the waning moon. So there are 2 Ekadashis in a month. So now we will say, what does Ekadashi mean exactly? Okay. Or what is the spiritual science behind it? Now the word Ekadashi means Eka is 1 and Dasi is 10. Okay, so when there is transformation of actions of the 10 senses, we have 10 senses and the mind, they all together make your 11 senses. That means on the day of Ekadashi, we are going to have all these 11 senses trying to control them, and then we are going to do a lot of service by which we can get closer to Krishna. Everybody understanding that part? If you understand, you're going to give a thumbs up. Okay. So now, Ekadashi is also called as Harivasara. Again, there is a split in the name. Hari. Who knows what is the meaning of Hari? Very good, Danya. Nobody else knows. I do not see any videos or I do not see anybody is raising your hands. So, Harivasara is what? That means it is the day of Hari, or it is the day of the Hari where Hari resides. See? It is also called as Madhavatithi. Again, Madhav is the name of Lord. Madhav is the name of whom? I see six participants who all have raised their hands. Let me check. Yes, Advait, can you tell what does Madhav, who is Madhav?
Mataji, it was an accident. I accidentally raised my hand.
Okay, Priyanka. No, sorry, this is...
Mehika.
Yeah, Mehika.
Mataji, Madhav is actually Krishna with the gopis. And that
it is Krishna's name, right? So again, Madhavatithi. So these all different names of the Ekadashi. Now we will see, we say that on an Ekadashi, you are supposed to do an Upavas. Upavas is what? I'm going to do fasting. Last time we saw the science behind fasting. So when you say Upavas, again the Upavas also has a split of name and we can understand the meaning. See, Upa means closer. And Vasa means stay. Now, whom am I going to get closer to? Anyone has an answer? Whom are we going to get closer? Very good, Danya Gopi. Krishna. We are going to get closer to Krishna. Okay, if you have your videos on, then only I will be able to see you. Yes, I see Vrinda, Ojasvi. Very good. Okay, so these are the simple meanings of Ekadashi. As last time we saw that Ekadashi is the 11th day of the moon cycle, right? Everybody is looking at the slides. You can see the slides. Okay, Ujwal Nita is there. Gaurangi is there. Anagya, Lipika, very good. And then what we saw? That okay, the 11th day, that means when the moon grows, then it comes at a point on the 11th day. And then there is also the full moon and the new moon, right? So the months are divided into 15 days. So, the 11th day from the first day, and again when the moon starts decreasing its size, again the 11th day from that will be the day of Ekadashi. Okay, that is the way how we celebrate, how we follow the Ekadashi. This was also the thing which we saw last time. Now we have to see what is the story behind it. Okay, now there is one story which we have seen in Srila Prabhupada's class also. Ujwal Nita, I'll ask you the question afterwards, okay? So it is seen that once Jamini Rishi, he asked his spiritual master, that is Vyasadeva. He said that Vyasadeva, oh Gurudev, you are such a best among all the sages. You have all the knowledge. Can I ask you a question? He said, I desire to hear what are the benefits when I am going to follow the Ekadashi. See, now there are two type of people in this world. Some of them say, I want to know the science behind it. I do not believe the scriptures. Then for them, we explain the science. Now there are some of them who are like God-loving people. And they say, please tell me what is the science behind the Ekadashi? How can I get closer to Krishna? What are the ways that I can become more dear to Krishna? Please tell me all the ways and means how I can get closer to Krishna. Okay? So we have to check whether we are only following science or also we are following the scriptures. And I see you all kids are so wonderful that you want to know the science also and you want to know the story also. So then, okay, I'm going to hide this. Yeah. So then when he asked, when Jamini Rishi asked Srila Vyasadeva, what did he say? Oh, Gurudev, when did Ekadashi take birth? He also had so many questions like us. When did Ekadashi take birth? What are the rules of Ekadashi? Why am I following it? And who is the Lord whom I am going to worship on the day of Ekadashi? And if I follow the Ekadashi, what am I going to get? If I do not follow the Ekadashi, what will happen to me? So like that, he had so many questions. Okay. So then Vyasa Srila Vyasadeva, what he said? That at the beginning of the material creation, what is it that the Lord created everything, right? The living being, the non-living being, everything was created by the Lord. It did not just come anywhere randomly. It was created by the Lord. And when the Lord created, it is seen that there are, see, when something good is created, there are some things which have bad effects also on our body, which are wrong things also. They also needed to be fixed. So what did the Lord do? Okay. So see, what did the Lord do was that there was a specific embodiment, that was a specific person created who was called as the Papa Purusha. Okay. And anybody who was doing bad things, wrong things, it was seen that he would be punished by that. So now we have to come at a question. I'm going to ask you some question over here. I want to see you all who are raising hands. Okay. Now, when you do something wrong or when you do something which you should not be doing, do your parents give you a lesson? Yes, you should not be doing this. Then sometimes your TV time is taken away or sometimes you're disciplined. Are you done, Sai? I'm going to ask you a question. Yes, Sai. Do you think that parents need to discipline the kids? How many of you think yes?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes. How many of you think yes, that they should be disciplining? Okay, they can talk. They will definitely talk to you. They will tell you, okay, this is wrong. No, Keshav, the parents should not be disciplining the kids. No? So what should they do? I'm unmuting you.
They should tell them.
Yeah, discipline instead of telling. Discipline instead of telling.
They should not get angry.
Okay, I'll tell your mom to smile and tell you things, okay? So whenever there is something wrong, parents will try to correct the children, okay? Now, the same way, when the Lord has told us some things, we have to also follow it. Now, we are going to see what it is. See? Now, the Lord thought, now I must create someone who will control all this. I've made the living beings, I've made the non-living things. Everything is made. Now, somebody has to control. Somebody has to take charge of it, that if anybody is doing wrong, somebody has to correct them. At this time, Sri Bhagwan created the personality known as Yamaraja. Okay? And the different hellish planetary systems were also created. We all know, right? We are on the Earth planet. Then there are, how many? Where is Akshita over here? Akshita, can you unmute yourself? Akshita is there? Or Prathamesh, whoever our regular Govinda group kids?
Yeah, Mataji, I'm here.
Yeah, can you tell us the planetary systems, Akshita? Satyayuga? No, the Satyaloka?
Satyaloka, Tapaloka, Janaloka, Mahaloka, Swargaloka, Bhurloka, Atala Vitala Sutala Talatala Mahatala Rasatala Patala.
Very good, Akshita, very good. So see, these are all the planetary systems. So all these are controlled. So the living entities who are very sinful, who are doing all sorts of wrong things, after death, they are sent over there. And that is the reason our scriptures tell us, don't do anything wrong. Unknowingly also do not do anything wrong. If you offend someone, go and beg for forgiveness. Okay? So if anyone is doing wrong, they are going to go to the hellish planet. Now there is one more thing over it. So now, what is the next? See, that means, the Yamaraja is like he has a court and then he does all the wrong things over done are going to be punished. People are going to be punished. So then once what happened, Lord Vishnu, he went to Yamaraja. And when he was sitting over there and having a nice time, he could hear all sorts of voices and all sorts of people crying. Okay. Then he asked, what is this, Yamaraj? What is this happening and why are people crying over here? Yamaraj said, oh Deva, the different living entities on this planetary systems who have fallen in the hellish planet due to all the wrong things, all the wrong karma they have done, they are having their punishment. Remember you told me to do all this job and they are having their punishment and that is the reason they are in pain. Now when, because it is whatever karma they have done, wrong things they have done, they are going to be paying for it. So now looking at this, our most merciful Lord, he felt, oh, this is not right, or there should be something done for this, he thought. Okay, the heart of Supreme Lord became, he start melting because of compassion. Remember, Lord Krishna is our eternal father. He has the most compassion for us. He loves us a lot. A lot means a lot, he loves us. And he wants us to come back. And he wants us to follow on the good path always. Okay. So what he said after the merciful Supreme Lord thought over it, and he had, and then he again started considering his things. He said he suddenly, when he was thinking out of compassion from him, what happened? There came a female form who came out of his compassion. She came out of the Lord's body, and that was Ekadashi. Okay, from his Lord's 11 senses, Ekadashi was born. Afterwards, what happened? The different sinful living entities, whoever used to, what the Lord said, whoever is going to follow this Ekadashi are going to be relieved from all the pain. I'm seeing that this in this hellish planet, people are going through so much of pain. And once you follow this Ekadashi, if you are going to follow Ekadashi with full heart and soul, then you will get relieved from all these miserable conditions, the Lord said. Okay? Then, what happened? Everybody started following Ekadashi. Everybody was very nice. And everybody started getting free from their reactions. Now what happened? The hellish planets were empty. There was nobody for punishment. And then Papa Purusha came. He said, what Lord, what have you done this? See, now nobody, whom am I going to punish? Or whom? How am I going to act? You made me for a specific reason. Now I have no reason to live in this world. All the people are doing Ekadashi and they are all getting relieved. And everybody is coming to your planet. Now, what am I supposed to do? You please find some way that I can also live in this world. Please give me some boon. Please give, help me out, he said. So Lord Vishnu became very pleased because he was also a surrendered soul, the Papa Purusha. I have become very pleased by your nice offerings, he said. He said, now what boon do you want? So what boon do you want, he asked, okay? So there could be a question for why do we fast, okay? The Papa Purusha, what he said, that everybody is so influenced by Ekadashi, I have no place to stay. Everywhere I go, there is people are doing Ekadashi. I have to run away from there. I'm running to the forest. I'm running from the animals. I'm running from the insects. There is nowhere that I can go. So he said, I cannot find a place where I can go free because I'm so scared of Ekadashi. See, the Papa Purusha, that means the bad things, the wrong things are also scared of Ekadashi. So what should I do? Then Vasudev said to Jemini, after saying the embodiment of sinful activities, fell down at the lotus feet of the Lord. And he said, my condition is very miserable. Please help me. Please find some alternative. Then the Lord said, what he said? Okay, he said, Papa Purusha, I understand what you're saying. Rise up, he said. I'm going to tell you what will happen now. He said, you do not need to be so sad anymore. Now, I will tell you that, see, those who people are doing Ekadashi, they are naturally going to be relieved. That I cannot take away. But there will be some people who will not follow Ekadashi. Okay? And also, I will give you a boon wherein you can stay in the grains on the day of Ekadashi. Okay? Now see, it becomes very hard for us to imagine things. But then what did the Lord say? That you can stay in those grains, in the foodstuffs, which are grains or which are pulses. Grains, you know, right? Wheat, rice. In those foodstuffs, you can stay for that day of Ekadashi. And those people who are not following Ekadashi, or those people who do not believe in the Lord, or those people who are doing these sinful activities, you can punish them. Okay? And that was the reason that why do we do not eat grains? Many of you asked, right? Why I do not have to eat grains? In the last class, we explained why was the scientific reason, right? The water content and everything we explained. But what is the science? What is the spiritual science behind it? That the Lord has given this boon to Papa Purusha. Okay? That whoever eat grain on Ekadashi, you can grab that person. See? And you should always remember Ekadashi. The Papa Purusha was also scared of Ekadashi. That means just remember how much potency Ekadashi has. See? And now when the Lord has told us that people should be doing Ekadashi, how many of you, now I want some of you, who is there? But let me see who is there, who is raising hands. Okay. Okay. Jagannath is raising hands. Now, so Jagannath, can you unmute yourself and answer me? Do we have to listen to our parents?
Yes, Mataji, we have to listen to our parents.
We have to listen to our parents, right? Okay, Keshav, then if your parents tell you something, do you have to do it? Should you be doing it?
Yeah, because then anyways, they're like, it will reach, it will happen, like everything.
Yes, because then we have to listen to our parents, right? And then, so now, Lipika, can you answer me? What is our relation with the Lord? Who is the Lord for us?
Krishna.
Yes, and what is his relation with us?
What do you mean?
What is he? Anybody can answer? Papadma. He's our?
He's our Lord.
Yes. Ujwal Nita, yes. Yes, Ujwal Nita. The Lord is our?
The Lord is our Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Yes, but one thing. Yes, Ashutosh.
Eternal Father.
Yes, the Lord is our Eternal Father. In this world when we come, we have our parents, right? But next life when we come, we will have different parents. But the Lord is our Eternal Father. Any life form we come, the Lord will always be our Father. Okay? So that is our relation with Him. And the Lord wants us to come closer to Him. So if we are going to listen to our parents in this life, why should we not listen to the Lord when He is telling us something? How many of you agree? Should we listen to Lord Krishna? Yes. And Lord Krishna is not coming every day and telling, right? It is written in the scriptures. So we have to follow the scriptures. And the scriptures tell us that you should be fasting on Ekadashi, so that all your sins are taken care of and you can become more and more focused on Krishna. Then somebody asks me, but Mataji, again, why not eating? I can eat all day. What will happen? I get up morning Ekadashi. I say, what do I eat? What do I eat? What do I eat? And then I lose my all brain. Oh, I have to go into the kitchen. I have to cook. I have to do something. No time for chanting. Right? If I go and cook, no time for chanting. That is the reason Ekadashi, we have to keep all our needs very little. Okay? Drink water, drink fruit juice, eat fruit. No need to cook over there. As much as you can. It is no hard and fast rule. If you feel you want to have sabudana, you can have that. But see to it that your needs are minimum so that we can come more closer to Krishna. How can I go closer to Krishna? Does that mean that I just go and sit near the altar? No, right? So what do? I have to keep chanting. So can everybody say with me, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama,
Rama, Hare Hare, Hare
Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna,
Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare
Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna,
Hare Hare,
Hare Hare,
Hare Rama,
Hare Rama,
Hare Rama,
What does Srila Prabhupada say?
Prabhupada
says that you have to minimize your...
Mataji, unmute yourself. Mataji, I'm muted.
So you have to minimize your activity on that day and see to it that you are taking more of your time in studying the scriptures. The more you study scriptures, the more you would come closer to Krishna. And everybody loves when your parents love you. Give me a thumbs up. Who all love, right? So if you want Krishna to love you, we can go a little bit more closer to Krishna, right? And that is only possible if I chant, right? And we did the chanting today. So we have seen that because of doing Ekadashi, I am going to come closer to Krishna. And that is what my eternal occupation is. What is occupation? Whatever I'm doing. And what is my eternal occupation? It is that I have to come closer to Krishna. I have to please Krishna. And when I do my sadhana nicely, Lord will really, really be happy. Okay? And that is the reason also we do Ekadashi. Because how many of you want that I have to be sinful? Anything I do wrong, I want the Lord to punish me? Do you want anybody to punish us? Do you want or no?
So leave it. Leave this. Keep it away.
Okay, I want to see all of you now. Okay, can somebody answer? Who is it? Anybody is raising your hand? Sanu.
Yes.
Sanu, I cannot see you. Okay, Sanu does not want to show. Okay, Nitya, anybody else who wants to answer? How many of you want to please? Yes, Sanu, how many want to please the Lord?
Brenda!
Yes.
Chanting.
Yes, now I want you to do something, right? You remember, I told you that we are going to make something. Tomorrow is Ekadashi. And I'm going to show you one thing which you can make an offer to the Lord and you can drink it that day. Okay, we have another 4 minutes. We will quickly make it. Everybody has your blenders with you? Very good, Jagdish. So I have yogurt over here with a little bit of, the milk malai also I have. So I have got some yogurt with me. And this yogurt.
Can I put it in?
Yes, this is a blender I have with me. Can you open this? Keep your car away. Okay, so I am putting, you can all do it along with me. Mataji, can I see them? Okay, I have to stop share, right? Yes, I stop share. Then I am going to see you all. Okay, so whoever has a blender, very good, Satvik. I see your blender, Karthik, very good. So I have this yogurt. I am going to add 1 cup of yogurt in my blender. Okay, can you keep this? Then I have 1/2 cup of milk, and that milk also, yes, Ashutosh, good. This milk also, I'm going to put it in the blender. Can you have this?
Yes.
Okay. Then I have 2 tablespoons of sugar, and I did not have cardamom powder. So I have taken a whole cardamom and I am going to put it in this. Okay, it's a very easy recipe. Then if you want, now you can just blend it like this and it will become a lassi. Okay, how many of you like lassi? Yes. And if at all you want to make any modification, you can have mango pieces. Okay, you can add mango pieces because I know my Krishna loves mangoes. So I'm going to add mango into it. Okay. And then I'll close this blender. I'll close the blender and then Ashutosh is going to blend it. Okay, now, yes, can you take it in the serving? Okay, then I'm going to put it in my Lord's glass, and then Ashu will be offering it. Okay, keep it back over there. Okay, Satvik, did you blend it? Karthik, did you blend it? Yes, Keshavi. Yes, Keshavi. I unmuted you, Keshavi. Yeah.
What if you don't have mangoes?
Then do not use mangoes. Only milk, yogurt, and sugar and cardamom. That is good. If you do not have mango, don't worry. Yes, Dhanya Gopi.
Okay.
Yes, Dhanya Gopi, you have some question to ask?
No, I had a comment that I like this recipe.
Yeah, it is very nice. And if the milk and yogurt is chilled, it is very nice, you know. Because yogurt, sometimes it is a lot sour. So if you add milk into it, it becomes very nice. In those, in some temples and all, you get it in containers. So this is a very fantastic recipe. Do not forget the milk part into it, okay?
Mama, you can put
that. Yeah, and you can say, you can show your pictures once you're done. Maybe you will not now, but whenever you're done, you can show the pictures also in the group.
I'm gonna have tomorrow, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, tomorrow is Ekadashi, right? Whenever you make it, you can send it. Everybody thumbs up?
Thumbs up.
Very good. So I think we'll move to your next class now. Mataji?
Yes, Mataji?
The next class, we can move, Mataji?
Yeah, not the Kavacham, right? We need another class.
So we will have Anshu and Krishna Chaitanya is there on call. Krishna Chaitanya, are you there on call? Or Anshu, are you there on call? Yes, Anshu is here on call. Radhika Mataji, is it okay if Anshu? Okay, Krishna Chaitanya is here. Yeah. Very good, Krishna Chaitanya. Anshu will be at 3:15, Mataji. Radhika Mataji?
Yeah. Yes, Mataji.
Yeah. Krishna Chaitanya, you can go ahead. Okay, I'm going to unmute you. Yeah. Okay, go ahead.
I will share my screen.
Can you share? You know how to share? Okay.
Can everyone see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. The glories of Narada Muni. So introduction. Thank you for all teachers for giving me this opportunity to speak about the glories of Narada Muni. Even though I'm not qualified to speak about such a great devotee, I'll speak what I know. Narada Muni is one of the Mahajans and he's a great devotee of Lord Vishnu. He's always traveling and chanting the names of Vishnu. He's the spiritual master of Vyasadev, Valmiki, Dhruva Maharaj, Mrugari, Prahlad Maharaj, Kailash, etc. We'll see the life story of Narada Muni. So once Vyasadeva was unhappy, even though he wrote all the Vedas, Upanishads, and Puranas, and by doing so, the people of Kali Yuga will read them, and their suffering will decrease. But no, in Kali Yuga, the people were suffering. And Vyasa did not understand why. He wrote all the Vedas, Upanishads, and Puranas, and people are learning. So why are they still sad? So Narada Muni goes to Vyasadeva to reveal the real reason of Vyasadeva's suffering. He needs to write Srimad Bhagavatam. Narada speaks to Vyasa. Oh, Vyasadeva, you've written all the Vedas, Upanishads, and Puranas, so you must be very happy. But Vyasa says, no. I'm not very happy even though I've written all the Vedas, Upanishads, Puranas. Please tell me why. Why am I not happy? So Narada Muni says it's because you have not written the glories of Lord Krishna. See, you've encouraged everyone in material life, but you have not talked about Krishna. So please talk about Krishna. Write the Srimad Bhagavatam. So Vyasadeva is going to write the Srimad Bhagavatam, but Narada decides to boost up Vyasadeva's confidence. So Narada relates his previous lives. In his previous life, he was a celestial being. He was very beautiful and he was very good at singing. So the Prajapatis asked him to sing for Lord Vishnu in the puja. So while the Prajapatis were having a puja, this person sings. He's singing the glories of Vishnu, but then he has all the women around him. He's feeling pride. Then he looks around. He sees great demigods, Indra, Chandra. So then he starts singing their glories. The Prajapati was very upset. So they cursed the man to become the son of a maidservant. So Narada became the son of a maidservant. And his mother, the maidservant, would serve the great devotees of Krishna. And Narada would also serve the great devotees of Krishna. He would eat the remnants of the great devotees. And like that, he would always be serving the great devotees. After some time, his mother died. When Narada would listen to the great devotees reading Srimad Bhagavatam, so he knew. So when his mother died, he decided to leave. His house and everything. He goes to pilgrimage and he does austerity. He does so much austerity of Krishna that Krishna shows his form, but only for a moment. And now Narada Muni is crying, oh Krishna, please come. And Krishna says, oh little boy, you cannot see me in this lifetime, but you will see me in your next lifetime. Your love for me has to grow. So Narada Muni kept praying to Lord Vishnu, and then he became in the spiritual form as Narada Muni. That's the life story of Narada. Why Narada Muni always travels? So Narada meet, this is from the Srimad Bhagavatam, not just, no one made it up. We did not make it up. Narada meets Daksha's sons. They were called the Haryaswas, and they were performing austerity. And so he comes and converts them into Krishna consciousness. They renounce. They decide not to marry. So now, but Daksha gets angry. Now they're supposed to help in the creation. So he asks Brahma, I'm mad at this Narada Muni, what should I do? So Brahma says, okay, here, you'll get one more wife. So Daksha gets one wife. With that, he gets 1,000 sons, Savala Swas. Narada again converts him into Krishna consciousness. Daksha becomes very angry. He wanted his sons to help him in creation. So he curses Narada that you will always keep roaming. You will not have any place to shelter. That's why Narada always travels. The story of an attached man. There was an attached man named Kailash. He was a boy. And Narada met him and asked him to take Krishna consciousness, but he said, no, I'm a boy, I have to study. So since Narada always travels, he left and came back. By now, Kailash was a man. He was an adult, he had a family to take care of. And Narada asked, will you take up the path of Krishna consciousness? He said, no, I have to take care of my sons. So Narada left, came back, and Kailash was old. He was a grandfather. Narada says, at least now will you take Krishna consciousness? No, I have to take care of my grandchildren. Narada leaves. Again, he comes back. He found out that Kailash died, and Kailash became a dog. Narada says, at least now will you try to take up the path of Krishna consciousness? And Kailash says, no. See, my sons, they're very careless, and there are robbers around here. I'm protecting them from the robbers. Narada again leaves and comes back to Kailash. He says, now will you at least come and take up the process of Krishna consciousness? When Kailash is a snake. And Kailash says, no, there are crops around here. I'm here to protect, my sons are very lazy, so I'm here to protect the crops because there are very big animals that come and destroy the crops, so I'm here to protect. Narada realizes this is going to take forever. He's just going to keep saying no. So he tells his sons, he tells Kailash's sons, there is a snake in the crops. Now Kailash's sons came with sticks and they start beating up Kailash, the snake. And Kailash said, please, please save me. But they would keep beating him and Kailash left. Then when Narada was leaving away, Kailash said, wait, I'll take the path of Krishna consciousness. So by Narada's mercy, Kailash took the process of Krishna consciousness and went back to God. There's a story of Murghari. This is a story from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Narada sees a dead animals, half dead animals. They're suffering so much. He sees a path of them. He follows the path and sees a hunter. He asks the hunter, who are you? And are you the one who is killing all these animals? He says, my name is Murghari. It's my profession to kill animals and half kill them. And I love to see the suffering on their face. This tradition has been taught from my father. And Narada says, why are you doing this all? Do you not know that you're making the animals suffer even more? Then why don't you just kill them? And he says, this is just a tradition. I do not know. And Narada says, you should not kill them, for you get even more sin than killing them. You're half killing them. And so you'll get even more sin. And Murghari says, I've never heard of anything like sin. Please tell me, how do I get rid of my sins? And Murghari surrenders unto Narada. Narada tells him to chant and renounce everything, to go and just chant. But Murghari says, how will I get food? So Narada says, I'll take care of that. So Narada goes to a nearby village and says, there's a great devotee here, a great devotee. And all the people come with foodstuffs ready to serve the great devotee. They see that the Murghari, the hunter, has changed into a great devotee. So they give him food. Murghari's wife tells Murghari, look at all the overload of food we have. And Murghari says, yeah, all this is due to the grace of Narada Muni. Let's just eat whatever we need and give the rest away. Let's continue chanting. So Narada again comes back and meets Murghari with a sage nearby in the picture, see. Murgari came to greet Narada, but there were ants in the way. So he was hopping and he was picking the ants away. And Narada asked, "What is this? What is the reason of all this?" And Murgari says, I'm coming to greet you, but there's ants in the way, ants. So I had to take them off. I had to hop so I wouldn't kill them. So now Narada was very happy, and the sage next to him said, who was glorifying Narada, "Oh Narada, you have converted this hunter into a person. This hunter who would enjoy half-killed animals is now not even wanting to hurt an ant." So that is the grace of Narada. Another story of Valmiki, who was in his past life Ratnakar. This is in Ramayana. There's a man named Ratnakar who would kill people and take their money. Narada asks him to ask his wife. So Narada comes and says, "Why are you doing all these sins? Why are you killing all these people? And you'll have to suffer these sins alone. Okay, ask your wife if she will take his sins and they will both suffer together." So Ratnakara asks his wife, "Will you take share my sins?" And the wife says, "No, I will take whatever you give me, the money and all, but I will not take your sins. You'll have to suffer so much." Now Ratnakara realizes, "Uh-oh, I will have to suffer in so much." So Ratnakara surrenders onto Narada. "Please help me. How will I take away my sins?" Narada knows a person like Ratnakara chanting Rama is hard. So he says, "Okay, chant Mara," which means death. He says, "Marama, Rama, 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 Rama," and you hear Rama. So he does so much austerity, saying the name of Rama, not Mara, Rama. And he does so much austerity that ants make a hill on him. And that's how he got his name, Valmiki. He takes a sage body, yes, Valmiki, one who's covered from anthill, or just anthill. Narada again visits Valmiki, and how Narada introduces Valmiki to Ram. Narada visits Valmiki, and Valmiki asks the questions. He says, "Who's the greatest? Who protects Dharma? Who's strong?" He asks all sorts of questions. And Narada replies, "Lord Ram is the person." This is how Valmiki gets into Ramayana. Okay. Nalukuvera and Manigriva, a story. Narada came to the heavenly planets and saw the sons of Kuvera, Nalukuvera and Manigriva. They were intoxicated. They were just looking at the wine and woman, and they were just happy. But Narada comes. Narada sees how they ignored him. Nalukuvera and Manigriva ignored Narada. Even the women there saw Narada and covered themselves up and greeted Narada. But these people, Nalukuvera and Manigriva, did not. So Narada felt compassionate to them. "What should I do? They're in such suffering." So Narada says, "Okay, I curse you to become trees. Curse you to become trees."
Krishna Chaitanya, unmute yourself.
Oh, okay. So Narada curses them to become trees out of compassion. So Nalukuvera and Manigriva asked for forgiveness. And he says, "You will meet Krishna after 1,000 years. So they became trees behind the house of Nanda Maharaj. Yeah, that's it. Any questions?
Thank you so much, Krishna Chaitanya. Very nice. So many stories, and you did it so well. Very nice.
Thank you, Mataji.
If Narada Muni saw everyone equal,
with compassion, why didn't he do something like making him a devotee like the other intoxicated people?
Which one, Kailash? This story?
No,
Nalukwera Manigriva?
Yeah.
Yeah? They were intoxicated?
Yeah, and then why didn't he make them a devotee?
He wanted to give them the pastime of Krishna. They don't even wear the clothes. So he understands that these people will not understand. So he decides to make, they're very intoxicated with wealth. So he wants to take away their wealth so they can focus on Krishna. That's why he took away their wealth and they became trees. So, yes.
Wonderful, Krishna Chaitanya. Thank you so much for coming on the call and giving us such a nice presentation.
Thank you, Mataji, for giving us
the opportunity. Have you on a Sunday also for a presentation, okay? Hi, Krishna. Radhika Mataji, is Anshu there on the call? Yeah. Krishna Chaitanya, if you stop the screen sharing, then she can come up.
Mataji, which name she is in?
Radhika Mataji, Anshu, I don't know. She was there on the call right now. So I think Radhika, we can just... Radhika Mataji, you're there on call? I think she was there. I don't see her.
Radhika or Anshu, can you raise your hand so that we can spot you?
Anshu, I have seen your name, Anshu. So I asked to unmute. Before that, I saw her on the call.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Anshu. You can explain what you are going to show us today. And then...
Thank you for this opportunity. I would like to talk some words about kirtan. So... So when
you join from two devices, can you off one device?
We were like happy and we were enjoying with in the spiritual world, but we got like tired and so we thought, oh, I want my own world. So then so Krishna said, okay, I will create a world for you. So he created the material world. When we were happy that we were so happy that we have a world for ourselves. But when we took birth in this world, then we got to know of the problems and the problems in this material world that we were suffering in this world now. And so to go back to the Goloka Vrindavan, we need to do some service. And one of the service is kirtan, and that is my favorite service that I like to do for Krishna. And so let's take some time to do some kirtan, and I would like to do some kirtan. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prastaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namine. You can repeat. Fine, whatever.
Everyone.
Swami.
We can't hear you. You're unmuted, but we can't.
Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare
Hare.
Anshu, can you unmute yourself?
No, someone else is saying it.
Yourself, please. I muted everybody.
Hi, Krishna.
Hi, Krishna Anshu. I love the way you explained the importance also, that why do we do kirtan and why are we chanting. Very nice, Anshu.
Thank you, Mataji.
Which is the tune you love, Anshu, a lot?
I like all the tunes, but I like this one tune, which is... Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. That is that's one of my favorite tunes that I like.
Anything else you want to share, or you want to sing that same tune again one more time? We loved it. The same tune you want to say again? You want to sing the same thing again, Anshu? Yeah, you are on mute.
So, Hare Krishna, anyone have any questions?
I think she did not hear your voice, Mataji.
Yeah. I think Ujwal Nita has a question. I'll let him ask. Ujwal Nita, you want to ask some question? You can unmute and ask. Ujwal Nita, Rishika and Ujwal Nita, you have some question, you can ask. Yes, Rishika. Ujwal Nita, you have any question, or you by mistake you did your hands, raised your hands? Okay, I think they are, okay. Thank you, Anshu, for coming over the call and showing us the tunes. And I really love the tune, which you also love.
Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you, Anshu. Hi, Bol. Mataji, whenever you're ready, can we...
Yes, Mataji. I'm opening, Mataji.
Yeah. Thank you, Anshu. Hare Krishna, Anshu.
Vrinda Mataji, can you on your video? Yes, Mataji.
Hare Krishna. Oh, so. Somebody has already shared it. Mataji?
Mataji?
Mataji, I'm also here. You have to send me to...
Okay. Okay, Mataji. I will send you, Mataji. One second.
Thank you.
It got missed. Okay, Mataji. You can start, Mataji.
Hare Krishna. I think they are all mute.
Yes, Mataji. Do you want me to unmute, or what do you think?
Because we will recite it, Mataji.
Okay.
We will first recite
Nasir. Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Okay. Can you all see the screen?
Yes, Mataji.
Like always, first we will recite all the shlokas from the beginning. Okay. So now when we are reciting, stop after the second verse. Okay. Then again we will start from third. Okay. Shall we all sing it together?
Yes, Mataji.
Okay, Mataji.
నరసింహకాకాంగం విభూతి విరూపాషకం.
Okay, let's say from the third one. Vritasyam Trinayanam
Trinayanam
Lakshmyalingit
Vamangam.
I cannot hear you all.
Chaturbhujam.
Yeah, let's start from Chaturbhujam, okay?
Chaturbhujam Komalam
Okay, are you all reciting? I cannot hear you again. Let's start with the seventh. Okay? Varut Kamala
Sambhasham Kritva Kavacham Pathe Narasimha Me Shirapatu Lokarathar Sambhavaha
Sarva Gopi Sambhavasa Thalam
Me Rakshatudmanam
Narasimha Me Shirapatu
To Soma
Suri
Lochna Smriti Me Patu Narahari Murir
स्तुति प्रियः आसम मे सिंहनासस्तु मुखम लक्ष्मी मुख प्रियः. What happened? You're all not reciting? Who are all reciting? Show me a thumbs up. Who are all saying it? Oh, you're all mute? Okay,
no,
okay. Okay, but you're all reciting, right? Okay, keep saying it. Let's start with the 10th, from 10th. Sarva vidyadhipah patu narsimha
namaha
vakravindu vadanam
tada pradvandita narsimha patu mekantam sudanka
ubharamandakrit
divyastara shobita bhujo narsimha patu me bhujo kahu me devarana varado
ब्रह्मांड
कोटया कत्या
गुरु मनोभव राज्य प्रथम पातु पादौ
मे नरसिंह
ओके. So let's move to the next two verses for today. Okay, repeat after me, okay?
Okay.
Manograha.
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 पूर्ववत्पूर्वतः पातु
पूर्वतः पातु
ततो ग्रह पूर्वतः पातु
पातु महावृषकर्जु नित महावीरस्तातु
महावीराग्रजोग्नितः
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 महाविष्णुरक्षेतु
महाविष्णुरक्षेतु
महाविष्णुरक्षेतु महाविष्णुर्दक्षिणेतु
महाविष्णुर्दक्षिणेतु
महाज्वालस्तु नैऋत्यौ
महाज्वालस्तु
महाज्वालस्तु नैऋत्यौ
महाज्वालस्तु
What this verse says. Who wants to read the translation?
Can I read it? I'm Jagannath.
It's Aru.
Okay, Jagannath, you want to read? Go ahead, please.
I want to read, Mataji.
Yes. Jagannath, can you say?
Okay, Mataji. May the ferocious personality protect me from the east. May he who is super.
Versus the great heroes protect me
to
the we cannot hear you to the
greatest hero protect me from the Saudis.
Hari Bol, Jagannath, can you say it?
Say it. To the greatest heroes protect me from the southeast, which is
from the east.
From the southeast, which is presided over by Agni, may the Supreme Vishnu protect me from the south, and may the person of blazing luster protect me from the southwest.
Very good. Thank you, Jagannath. I will say it again. Please recite after me, okay? Manograha purvatah patu.
Manograha parvato patu
Mahaviragrajognitaha
Mahaviragrajognitaha
Mahavishnurdakshinetu
Mahavishnurdakshinetu
Mahajwalastu nairutyau
Mahajwalastu nairutyau
I'm going to say again, continuously the first line, okay? Mahagraha purvatu
Mahavishnurdakshinetu
Mano
Okay, I'll say it again, okay? Mahograha purvatah
Mahavishnurdakshinetu
Mahajwalastu
Mahavishnurdakshinetu
Mahajwalastu Okay. Is everyone okay with this verse?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji. The next one, okay?
Okay.
Paschime patu sarve.
Paschime
patu sarve sho.
Paschime patu sarve
sho.
Paschime
sarvato mukhah.
Dishime sarvato mukhah.
Paschime sarvato mukhah.
Dishime sarvato mukhah.
नरसिंह पातु वायव्याम सौम्याम भूषण विग्रह
सौम्याम भूषण विग्रह
Mataji, can I do it? Okay, I thought Sudeshna was going to, because I told her.
Mataji, I'm going to unmute Sudeshna. You also unmute Mataji. Everybody is muted now. Only Sudeshna is going to repeat.
May the Lord of everything protect me from the West. His faces are everywhere, so please may he protect me from this direction. May Lord Narasimha protect me from the northwest, which is
predominated
by Vayu, and may he who is in itself is supreme ornament protect me from the north where Soma resides.
Okay, so these two verses, if you notice, the first verse says it is a prayer to Narasimha Dev to protect us from which all directions? In the first one, east, southeast, and then south and southwest. So the first verse talks about this direction, and we are praying to Lord Narasimha Dev to protect us from these directions. And now the second verse, the 18th one, what all directions are mentioned in there? West, northwest, and north.
West.
Yes, west, northwest, and north. So this is the verse which is like a prayer to Lord Narasimha Dev to protect us from these directions. Okay, so I'm going to say the second one again two times. Please recite after me, okay? Paschime patu sarvesho.
Paschime patu sarvesho. Ah, yaar ka ma phone hai?
Sarvato mukha.
Yaar ka ma phone
hai? Simha patu sarvesho. Is anyone saying? Everyone, please mute if you're not listening. Those who are reciting, please say. Samyam Bhushana Vigraha.
Samyam Bhushana Vigraha.
Now I'm going to say the first line continuously and then the second one. Please recite after me. Paschime patu sarvesho.
Paschime patu sarvesho. Paschime patu sarvesho.
Paschime patu sarvesho.
Narasimha patu vayam yam samyam. Samyam bhushana vigraha.
Very good. Nicely recited. Now, please practice these verses at home. We will also share it in the group. And please practice the previous verses also, okay? Now we will move to the Devanagari script class.
How many letters are we going to learn today?
Today also 5.
Okay, Mataji, thank you.
Which one? I don't know. Write something else. Write in something.
Okay.
Mataji, what happened?
Yeah, I'm just trying to share my taking time. Yes. Okay, can you all see?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
So today's first letter consonant is T. Can you all say T?
T.
So last time the first one was T, but this is different one. Although you can see T here, the pronunciation is T. T. You have to use your tongue between your teeth. T. Okay. T. The first stroke is the vertical line, and the second one is like this. It goes like this. Okay, and the third one is on top. I'm going to show you here. The first one.
Oh, this time.
Mataji, like this?
Let me show you. Can you all? Okay.
Mataji?
Yes.
Is it like
correct? Yes, let's see what is the example. Taruhu. Taruhu means
tree.
Taruhu.
After you all write, just show me your notebooks, okay? Let me know when you are done then. So I can see. Yeah, very good.
Mataji,
very nice. Everyone is writing.
Mataji, okay. I wrote both of them.
Okay, you're all clear with this word, this letter?
Yes,
Mataji.
Okay, very good. Let's go to the next one. Is it okay? Everyone is done, right? Who is not done yet?
I'm done with second line also.
Okay, good. So next one is Tha.
Shama Gauri.
Very nice, Shama Gauri. Good job. Can you write the next one now? Tha.
Oh.
Tha. Can you all say Tha?
I'm done.
Tha.
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 So even though it is T and H, T and H, the T and H is given, right? Last time we saw was T, T. This is T. Again, you have to use your tongue and teeth. T. T is different and H is different. T. And the stroke goes like this. The first one is like this. And it goes up here and goes back. And then there is a line.
Mommy, do you know what mountain is in Sanskrit?
I think you all can
hear it.
Okay, I'll start showing the stroke, okay?
The
H. her. Can you see?
Yes.
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 Mataji.
Okay. You show your notebooks when you're done. I want to see how you are did this time. Tha is a little bit tricky one, right? Or it was okay. Was it easy?
Yeah.
Yes, Mataji, it's pretty
easy. Easy, right?
Yes, Mataji.
Now you all have become expert, I think, right? Very good. You all are doing very nice. I can see. Good. Now let's go to the example.
I did the third line also.
Mataji, is the next one dha?
Nothing.
Let's see. Let's see the example first. Thaha. Thaha means?
Mounting.
Mounting. Mountain.
Thaha.
Simple word, right? Simple words.
Yeah.
Okay. Will I move to the next one?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
The.
Yes, Mataji.
The. Can you all say the?
The.
Simple the. No H sound. The.
The.
The. And although there is the here, it's not the. It's the. Use your tongue again.
The.
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 The. So you know how to write dha, right? So you just have to extend it. That becomes the. This is the first stroke. And the stroke goes like this. And till here we wrote dha, dha, right? Dha. Remember?
Right.
So you have to extend it. Okay?
Ma!
What did you say?
Mama!
All right. Can I see your notebooks?
Yes.
Okay, let's read the example first. Dantaha. Dantaha. So here, even though there is half na, that na, I think we will learn that na now. But even if you want, you can put anuswar above the, like this dot. Like how we learned before. Done. And then.
Mama, do you know what is dantaha?
So this is another way of writing dantaha.
Another way you can write
dantaha.
Yeah, you can also write the anuswar on top.
Okay. Yeah.
Mataji. Next
letter,
Mataji.
Next one is dha. Dha. Dha and her together makes dha. First stroke goes like this. It's like gha. You remember gha? But there is no this. There is this part is not there for gha. So you just have to write this part, and it goes up like this.
Daddy, is it like this?
Who is showing me?
Yes, I'm showing you.
Satvik?
I'm showing you.
Is it Satvik? Yeah, Satvik, correct.
Mataji, is this one?
Like this?
Yes, everyone is correct. Correct, Samarth. Very good, Radhika, Rasika, very good. Keep practicing at home also. Okay? Yeah, very good. Yes, I'm going to the example. Dhanuhu. Dhanuhu means bow. And what was the name for the arrow? We already learned it.
Dhanuhu.
Dhanuhu.
Banaha.
Oh, I think we just have a minute. You're all done? Next is Na. Next is Na. So the first stroke is like this, and this is the second one. And the vertical one is third, and the horizontal one last. Goes like this.
Is it like this?
Can you see it?
Mataji,
is it like this?
Yes, sweet. Correct. Yes, who is it?
Tanu.
Yes, Tanu.
What was the other one before Na?
Before Na was 1 minute.
Dha.
Dha.
Okay.
Dha. So then for Na, the example is Nabha.
Nabaha
means sky.
Nabaha.
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 I finished.
Both got changed.
Can you all show me your notebooks? I think I just want to get over now.
I don't have a notebook, but I'm using piece of paper.
Ujjala Nithai, very good.
Mataji, like
Shri, very nice.
Mataji, stop your sharing.
Mataji.
Yes, yes, Mataji. Mataji, so you're all done, right? I will stop sharing the screen.
Mataji.
Okay, Mataji.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Bye.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Everyone practice at home.
Okay. Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.